two friends. As close as brothers. Until war forced them continents apart.
It's a very moving story about three people, essentially, about Amir, Hassan, these two best friends, and then Barbara, the father. And these three people who somehow don't know how to love each other properly, but as well, there's this act of betrayal. And, you know, Amir spends his life dealing with that and then, you know, finally redeeming himself. I was called, it was coincidentally the day after the premiere for United 93, and asked to come in and audition for the film. I hadn't read the book at that point when I was called, so I promptly that day went out and bought the book. And read it a few days later in one sitting. Became the only person to have read the book, possibly about to play the part of Amir, and then of course getting to do so. I read the book and loved it and couldn't wait to get my hands on it. I think at root it's the story and the fact that it's a very moving, beautiful story that's made the book successful. I think on top of that, there's the thing, you know, a lot of people find it very refreshing to see Afghanistan or that part of the world seen in this light through the prism of a family human story rather than through the prism of political violence and negative stereotyping. And I think that the feeling that that's refreshing somehow as well gives it an extra boost. Clearly there've been concerns raised that there could be some adverse reactions in Afghanistan, which thankfully hasn't been the case up until now. But of course, out of fear for the safety of the boys, quite rightly the decision's been taken to take them out of the country as a precautionary preemptive measure, so that if anything were to happen, we know that they're safe, because clearly they're very, very important to us. I first met them in Kabul, I learned to fly a kite with them, and I spent 4 months of my shoot with them, watching them every day on set. But I'm very, very hopeful because I have met a wealth of Afghans who've seen the film both here and elsewhere, and the reaction has, across the board, been immensely positive, has recognised what we were talking about earlier, essentially the humanism of the film, has recognised it as telling their story. And I've met Iranians who've said the same to me, I've met Uzbeks who've said the same to me. Because as well it's a film about an immigrant experience, about leaving your country for whatever reason it might be, because it's war-torn or otherwise. I've met Bosnians who've told me the same things, I've met Armenians who've told me the same thing. But particularly one woman, an Afghan lady, who I remember stood up and said, "Thank you. I feel represented. I feel like you've shared my history and my culture in a way that I recognize and I'm happy to share. And I've not seen done before in this way."
From the director of Finding Neverland and Monsters Ball.
"I dream that my son will grow up to be a good person. A free person. I dream that someday you will return to revisit the land of our childhood. I dream that flowers will bloom in the streets again, and kites will fly in the